Back in 2009, Browning launched the Maxxis shotgun, and being a shotgun aficionado, I had to have one. A couple years later, they launched the Wicked Wings version, so I upgraded. And now, they've launched the new Maxxis 2, and I'm sure all you hardcore shooters want to know if it's truly worth the added dollars. We put it to the test, and we're going to show you the difference. Let's do a quick overview of the original Maxxis. The big thing with this shotgun was the gas operating system. It is what's called a power drive system. It is a piston design that delivered 18% less felt recoil and 44% less muzzle jump. This was a huge hit for Browning and one of the reasons I love my Maxxis. The Inflex Technology recoil pad was a huge improvement to older style recoil pads and once again reduced the felt recoil. The Speed Load Plus did two things. First, is that it allowed the first shell dumped into the magazine to automatically feed into the chamber instead of dropping it into the chamber and then pushing the bolt release button. You can still do that if you like, however, having it in this position to load and keep loading makes the process faster. Better yet, you can unload the shells in your magazine without cycling the bolt. This is a big benefit when you're sitting over a spread of duck decoys and a flock of honkers lock up. You can quickly load some heavier shots. It shoots 3.5-inch magnum loads all the way down to light game loads. The Vector Pro forcing cone and the Invector Plus choke tubes deliver very uniform loads with everything from number 8 birdshot up to the heaviest goose loads. The Speed Lock forearm was something very unique to the design. It was a push button and a slide off instead of the screw on cap. The positive is that even after getting dirty and nasty from lots of shooting and drudging in and out of the duck blind, it was still easy to remove. However, it didn't allow for an extended magazine tube, which was a problem come spring snow goose season when I wanted more than 4 shots. As with a veteran company like Browning, when they launched the new Maxxis 2 10 years later, you would expect a lot of upgrades, and Browning definitely didn't disappoint. Just looking at it out of the box, the Inflex recoil pad is 1.5 inches, and they have added Softflex cheek pads. The forearm is trimmed down a bit and has rubber over molding on it as well as the pistol grip. The trigger guard is now ramped for easier feeding and especially when you're doing it in the dark. The bolt and bolt release button is significantly larger than the original. My Wicked Wings version has a good sized bolt release and I really liked it when wearing gloves. This is still a gas operated shotgun with the power drive system, but with 12 years of experience, there had to be improvements. This one has larger exhaust ports, which allows gases on heavier loads to dump quicker, and the piston has a 20% longer stroke, which will allow you to function better with lighter loads. Overall, it delivers less felt recoil than even before, as well as less muzzle jump. This allows you to get back on target for a quick follow-up shot. Speed Load Plus is still there. Chamber and bore are chrome, and this helps with corrosion when heating up and cooling down on those cold mornings. It comes with extended choke tubes and a fiber optics front sight and an ivory bead middle post. You know, all of these changes are really good improvements and very well thought out changes, but the one change that really makes you sit up and take notice and make this worth investing is the ability to add an extended magazine tube here. This thing no longer has to stay in the gun safe when it comes early season snow goose, when we can shoot as many shells we want. I can screw on the Briley extension. I can throw in 10 3-inch mag shells and we're ready to roll. It comes in several different models and with either a 26-inch or 28-inch barrel, as well as 3 and 3.5-inch chambering. One of the things for sure, this new Maxxis 2 is definitely worth the upgrade.